welcome to our channel. So today we're bringing you a video where we show you our like tips and how we study Korean for people that is really busy. Like, it's realistic, exactly.
Yeah, realistic because...
because, I mean, we work full-time and I commute several hours a day. So I wake up at 6 a.m. and get home at 8 p.m. and I'm all day outside. So it's like, how do I study Korean?
You just...
I basically don't. I should do it more than I do. But we have several tips and...
several things you can
do. In general, that you can like maybe do or are useful for you. And we will like explain everything that we've been like learning these years that it's like useful, basically.
Yeah.
Feel like, oh, this I could do it in the bus while I commute, or this I could do it while I'm cooking, or this...
Just different things that you can like get used to doing, and maybe it's not like just studying, but it can help
you. And I mean, obviously, it will be a slower process rather than you study every day a few hours, which I wish, but I just can't.
No, there's no time.
So that's basically why we wanted to do this video, in case it's helpful for anyone out there. And yes, let's start. We have like a list of several things in this cute like notebook. It's really cute outside. Inside it's just
a full mess.
But yeah, we have like a list of things and we'll go like over them.
And yes, yes.
First of all.
First thing, like the basic that you need, like it's a base. But yeah.
I mean, you can do it all alone, but for us it's helpful to have like someone, and we have like a tutor. We do class like once a week. Two hours. Which obviously I would like to do more, but it's
just
impossible.
Like there's no
because we have
more
to do
time.
It after work. When and I get home. So that's really late.
Yeah, and both of us are working full time. Our teacher is also working full time. So yeah, there's no way you can do
and
more.
And luckily
than that.
Our teacher comes to our like house, so it's easier for us then to like reduce the time that we spend during class. It works basically because you can do it on your own, but with a native speaker, she can explain the tips.
Maybe she talks to you in Korean, so that's already gonna help.
Yes, and also, for example, she studied like Spanish, and she speaks Spanish perfectly. So she understands when we have some problems, because she had the same problems while studying Spanish.
Yeah, maybe there's some like grammar that you don't have like an exact translation to your language. But she knows that because she has already studied that, so it's very helpful.
Yes. We're gonna show you a bit the books that we use. We first started Korean while we were in an academy in summer for like a month, and then we started in an academy. But we were there just 3 months because it was terrible. The teacher was terrible, it was bad. But then we started with this book, the Kyungi.
The Kyungi University books.
And then our teacher uses this one too. So actually it was like perfect.
Perfect.
We're now in the book 3. We're working on it. And for example, the first book and the second book has like explanation like in
both Korean and English.
Yeah, but in this
from
one, no.
Third one, it's just in Korean. So
that's why you need a teacher, because you don't understand anything, basically. And the grammar is a bit more complicated, because sometimes it's like the grammar that you already learned, but some things that might change if you use it differently.
Like, there's like this exception that you don't know, and you're like, oh, wait, no.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
Making mistakes is fine, people.
Yeah, you learn like that.
I just
so.
Don't care. But yeah, this is the book that we use as for like learning the grammar and basically.
Yeah, that's the, like the base of our books.
Then she always like give us some like sheets. In general, like webtoons or just in general vocabulary. And then we also have like the Sogang. We have like the student's book. In the computer, and what we bought was the workbook, because obviously like the student's book it's fine if you have it on the computer, but the workbook I think you need it, so we got like the levels that we are basically like working on, and I love them, to be honest. The exercises are easier. I mean, in general, I just love them, and it's more like when you learn other languages, that it's like more fun in a weird way.
It's more like there's like some conversation of
yeah,
someone
yeah.
And
you
like
can
that.
And you can understand better rather than the book, because the book is a bit like more formal,
mm-hmm.
and here is more like
a little bit easier.
It's
like,
easier in general.
Yeah, like maybe the words are not that formal.
Yeah, yeah,
like
yeah.
something that you're gonna use on your everyday life.
And for example, the student's book, you have like the vocabulary too.
Yes, you have
the
beginning.
Vocabulary is a word that I struggle. Okay, saying it's not easy. Vocabulary.
Have it at the beginning of the
yes.
lesson, and then you have exercises where you're gonna use that.
Yes. Number three. It's when we try to do homework. Okay.
And it's try because
some
days it's not always a success.
It's not always a success because normally we do it on Sundays, but right now we are also like doing YouTube, and also we like to go out because we are always working.
You're not gonna use like all the free time you have to,
yeah.
to study.
And basically, if I don't have time, what I do, it like I get the grammar that we need instead of doing the homework. And I just like summarize it,
yeah,
like super small, just to, so I can remember if I need it and everything like that.
Yeah, I have that too, and it's like mostly like first, like what is it? Like
yeah.
what are you talking
about? And examples.
And then examples,
yeah.
because otherwise if you just have like the explanation, you're like, okay, but
no,
still
no,
I
need examples mostly.
Then just like write some sentences using that and it's
yes.
like, okay.
And then I also have
another
like notebook where I note all the
vocabulary.
Thank you. All of that. We have a lesson, then when I have time, I just try to like
write everything down.
Yes,
I mean, normally I don't normally go back to this notebook and
no.
check the
we should
yeah but
we don't
no I don't but just writing it
yeah.
down sometimes just like or already
yeah,
like so.
And even I have a section here which is like useful phrases that sometimes our like teacher says and I'm like, oh, maybe I need that. And for example, today I invite, I have them written it here and this should be like the base, at least for us, a base which is like a teacher, the books that you need. And then
do what the teacher tells you.
Yes. And for example, we use these books, but for example, there's Talk to Me in Korean that have like really nice books
oh,
also.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
if you want to do it all on your own, I recommend those books. Talk to Me in Korean is specialized if you want to learn it alone.
Alone. They also have like the lessons online.
Yeah,
like
so
you need
like,
the
yeah.
books.
Then, now we'll go for the tips. Okay? Basically. And I say first like the commuting, which is something that I try to do. And in the morning, I have to be honest, I try like 10-15 minutes and then I fall asleep. Look, it happens.
It's
too
fine.
Early.
It's fine.
Well, I do it commuting, but maybe you can do it while you have to wait for something.
Yeah,
or
sometimes I'm doing it while I'm having breakfast or something
also.
Like that.
So first is like Talk to Me in Korea podcast, because on Spotify they have like the podcast. And sometimes I listen to the ones that I already know the grammar.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it's like, so I can listen again with more examples and I like recheck, let's say.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. They have
yeah.
like, it's two people and they are like kind of having a conversation
they,
and
yeah.
talking about what is this grammar?
Yes.
And then they
yeah.
use like examples in English and then in Korean or the other way around.
Yeah, it's really nice. And also sometimes I listen to the podcast that they have that are just like real conversations,
mm-hmm.
which are really short. And I mean, you can go by levels.
Yes.
So for example, the level 1 and 2, when I listen to them,
you're
it's like really easy.
It.
But in the morning, it's like you listen to Korean, which is like helping your
yeah.
mind.
It's nice to revise because there are some stuff that you maybe did like level 1 and
yeah.
you don't remember.
You don't remember. I mean, it's obvious. And then another thing that like I use is an app Link. Well, we
Link
both use it. Link
yeah.
up. Link up. It's called Link. Here I have like folder. Yeah, folder. But I have like several like things. For example, I have like some other apps also besides Link, which is like topic words, which is a like
vocabulary.
And you just like dig, basically.
Yeah, it's like, do you know this one?
Yes.
Yes. Do you know this one?
No.
And then
you just keep
just
repeating, yes.
And revise.
But the Link app is more similar to
Duolingo?
Duolingo, yeah. It's not only for Korean, there are like several languages.
Yeah.
It's really cute, the monkey. And for example, here you have speaking, writing, and exam. Let's do the first one. See, they give you like the verb and then they make like
a
sentence and you can listen to it and you can even play it like a slower. See? Fun. But it's like telling you the new vocabulary. And then you have like to choose and you have also the Romanized? How do you say it?
Like
written how it should
in our
in English.
Yeah. Okay. It's weird.
It's weird. That. But in the beginning you need it. That's right. And for the two gotta good. That we know. Well see. And then you can like match like see. And see sometimes they like come up with like a special explanation of some things, location and gotta. And several things like that, so you can like understand better.
Yeah, instead of just listening and playing.
And then you also need to like they tell you like the phrase in like Korean, and then you just
need to put the translation in English. You have the word and you just choose.
Go to school. And they also make like a full conversation.
벌써 밥 먹었어요?
아직요.
같이
네. Which is really useful. It's basic but useful.
Yeah,
you can replay like, it, translate it, and then you need like to put everything. This part is the one that is a bit iffy for me because now, like this is weird. I prefer it to be in Korean.
Yeah, written in Korean. Once you like are used to reading in Korean, yeah. It's weird to see it like.
Yeah, it's weird.
Like I don't really.
But yes, and you do this and it's like the lesson is done and I'm gonna skip now because any concentration. But yes, this is like the main app that I use.
And we will leave the link down below so you can go
out. You can go check it out down below. It's really nice. I really like it. Besides the commuting now, we'll go to like to the next tips, which is like songs. It's really easy, basic, but get a song that you think that you already understand some things. For example, it happened, you listen to it,
happens,
or a song that you really like and you listen to it a lot, so you just basically go to Google or YouTube and you like check for the
lyrics
in Korean and in English, Spanish, any like language you speak and you
whatever.
Try to read it.
First. Try to read it and you're like, okay, do I understand this?
I understand this part, for example.
This word, I know what that means, but I don't understand the full sentence.
And then there are some songs that we already sing. That we know the lyrics, or at least some parts. You also understand what they are saying without thinking what they are saying, because you already like know it.
But just listening to, in general, listening to songs in Korean, like sometimes there's, we've done like a grammar lesson, and then there's like this particular grammar word, that then you start like hearing in every song, and you're like, oh, now I understand.
Now I understand
what it means, and then you can never like not hear that.
Yeah, which is good. And then there's another option that is like another thing that you can do. Which is Korean blogs on YouTube or cooking blogs.
Yes,
because they are like really chill and calm.
It's like very nice, like aesthetically
really nice.
Yeah.
And they have it written in Korean also, and I think most of the times they have also the English.
You can put also the English one.
But in general, if you try to like read the Korean, if you have a bit more of a level, you can understand most of it. And as I said, like it's calm, it's slow, the blog
and normally
everything.
It's like a silent blog and they have like, they just write it down.
Yes,
I love watching The cooking ones. It always the food looks amazing.
Yeah.
And it's like you're using it but you're like not thinking too much.
Yeah.
So love that.
It's really easy and they are short. See, you have to try to like use things or learn Korean the way that you can. Because if you compare yourself with someone that is like studying in Korea every day at university Korean 4 hours,
of course it's
not gonna be the same. But we study 2 hours after work, which is basically that. So we have to adapt it our way. It's slower, yes. But we are doing our thing. It's working for us.
And
slowly. Obviously, you want to learn more. You want to be faster. But it's really not possible.
No.
So you have to be realistic with your situation. You have to do it your own way. The important thing is that you are constantly, like, not only Korean, but any language you're learning, constantly in touch with it. Even if it's just listening to the music or watching a drama during the day, just 1 hour, or if you can only watch
you can do
half an hour.
And wherever you find that you like.
That you get comfortable with the language.
Yeah.
Then another thing that we do is, like, we call it Korean time, okay?
Carla calls it Korean time.
Well, I call it Korean time. Okay, even if it's by yourself, or you have like a friend, remember, we live together and we do a lot of things together. We try sometimes, for example, when we go to the supermarket, we only speak Korean, or we only or try only to speak Korean.
Yeah.
Which is like, maybe we look at it like stupid, but it works. Sometimes it's like you try to use more things. And for example, if one speaks in our language, we're like, no, Hanguk-go.
To me, like the hardest part is like
speaking.
Just speaking, because there's things you know, but then you don't find the way to use it.
To use it, or you forget,
or
you need to talk to people also, but that's really difficult if you're not there, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to do it like this. The other option that we have is by yourself, is for example when you shower. When I shower, I try to make conversations in my head.
Yeah, and then it's easier, like, then you try to write them down, and like, it never
comes up. Or for example, when our teacher asks something, it's like, I don't know. But then you're showering and you're like, wow, I could have said that, wow, oh my god. This is really nice.
Every little thing that you do.
And I remember when we like were studying, not just studying like English, but when you're in like high school and everything, that you have to study English because it's compulsory.
Yes.
But I remember I was already like showering with full conversations in my mind. And
yes.
I still do it. When I'm in the shower, if I don't force myself to like speak Korean, I normally think in English, which is really funny. So basically, these are our tips or things that we do that make us like
that's
easier.
How we learn Korean.
Yes. Obviously, as we said, it's like really relative. Some people will be easier, more difficult, depend on the time that you have. But
yeah, maybe some things
don't compare yourself to the other.
Yeah, maybe some things you're not gonna like, so just like avoid it.
Just if you wanna learn a language, Korean or any other language,
anything. I
just
think you can apply everything like to the language you want to learn.
Yeah, it's not only for Korean.
No, of course not.
This is all that we do, and I hope it's like really useful for you guys.
Hopefully.
And if not, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe to our channel and give a like.